Okay, this video is going to be about solving word problems with addition and subtraction. And as you probably know, the most difficult thing about word problems is just setting them up right. So let's take a look at some problems and see how to set them up. Okay, this one tells us that Alice and Bob earned a total of $87. If Bob earned $24, how much did Alice earn? Okay, so what it's telling me in this first sentence is that the two amounts, the amount that Alice earned plus the amount that Bob earned, added together, totaled, was $87. So I'm going to say that A is the amount that Alice earned, and B is the amount that Bob earned. And when I add these two together, I get 87. And then the problem tells me that Bob earned $24. So the amount of money that Bob earned is 24, which means instead of this B, I can write 24. So now I just have A plus 24 equals 87. And now the problem's set up. So the worst part is over. Let's just isolate the A. I'll subtract 24 from both sides. On the left side, I get A. That's the amount that Alice earned. And on the right side, I get, let's see, 7 minus 4 is 3. 8 minus 2 is 6. So Alice earned $63. And I can check this. Let's see. Alice and Bob earned a total of $87. So Alice earned $63. And Bob earned $24. So 63 plus 24 should equal 87. Adding these together, the 3 plus the 4 is going to give me a 7. 6 plus 2 will give me an 8. 87 equals 87. So my answer checked. Alice earned $63. Here's another one. The length of a rectangle is 5 feet more than the width. If the length is 17 feet, how wide is the rectangle? Sometimes it's nice to draw a picture. Might not be necessary with this, but it can't hurt. So we've got a rectangle, and they're telling us we've got a length and a width, and we're comparing the two of them. It says the length is 5 feet more than the width. So if I add 5 feet to the width, I should get the length. So in other words, the length is the same as the width plus 5 feet. And the other thing it tells me is that the length is 17 feet. Okay, so instead of the L, I'm going to put in 17. So 17 equals W for the width. Plus 5. And now I want to find out what the width is, so I'll subtract 5 from both sides. 17 minus 5 is 12, and that's going to be the width, 12 feet. And let's see if this checks. So what I'm thinking is that the width is 12 feet, and the length is, they told us the length, that was 17. And it says the length is 5 feet more than the width. Well, 17 is 5 more than 12. So this answer will check. When you write your answer, by the way, don't just leave it as 12 equals W. What you want to write is that the width is 12 feet. Okay? All right, one more. The temperature today is 17 degrees higher than the temperature yesterday. So we're comparing two things. We're comparing the temperature today, I'm going to use a T for today, and the temperature yesterday, I'll use a Y for yesterday. And it says that the temperature today is 17 degrees higher than the temperature yesterday. So if I add 17 to today's temperature, to yesterday's temperature, I should get today's temperature. So now I've got an equation. I've also got more information. Today's temperature was 8 degrees above zero. Oh, that's good. So I can, instead of the T for today, I can put in an 8. 8 equals Y plus 17. And it wants me to find yesterday's temperature. Okay, so I'll subtract 17 from both sides. That means I've got my Y all by itself on the right side, which is fine. And I've got 8 minus 17. That'll be a negative number. And let's think 8 minus 17 is going to be 9. So the temperature, yesterday's temperature, was 9 degrees below zero. And once again, we can check this also. So we've got today's temperature. Today's temperature was 8, and yesterday's was negative 9. And what we want to do is see if when we add 17 to yesterday's temperature, we get an 8. So negative 9 plus 17. Let's see if that equals 8. Negative 9 plus 17 is 8. So this answer will check. And again, you're going to write down, you're not going to leave the answer like this. You'll write down yesterday's temperature was negative 9 degrees or 9 degrees below zero. Okay, that's all there is to it for these. The main thing, like I said, is to set your problem up carefully. And once you've done that, you should be fine. So take care. I'll see you next time.